Can we make Derek Theler cry? We'll see. How many episodes of Baby Daddy?
We did 100 episodes of that show. Yeah.
And is that, do you look like as a very fond chapter?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, it was actually my first real big gig.
Right.
And we became a family. We worked together for 5 years. It was amazing.
Yeah.
And then, I don't know. I mean, I think that's a good number and a perfect amount of time. Mm-hmm. Or if you had your druthers, that would go on for 200 episodes in 10 years.
You know, I wish we would have done one more season.
Okay. Mm.
Because it kind of had an abrupt ending for me. But if we would have had one more, I would have enjoyed it.
All right. And speaking of weddings, in real life, you just came from a wedding.
I just came from one in New Orleans, yeah. And in Denver.
Wow.
Oh.
Yeah.
All
my friends are getting married.
Yeah.
What does that mean for you?
The pressure?
I don't know if I'm feeling the pressure, but, you know, we're getting a little bit older. It's not so bad, I think.
Well, you're like 27 or it's like...
I'm a little over 30 now.
All right, okay. All right, fair enough.
Yeah.
November, of course, is National Diabetes Awareness Month. You are deeply involved in the JDRF One Walk. Before we talk about your team, and Frank's, of course, involved in the Well, such a great event. You were diagnosed at 3.
Yeah,
And how has it impacted your life from 3 till now?
Type 1 diabetes is a pretty difficult disease to manage, and it's scary for people who are diagnosed. And I was diagnosed at 3 years old. My sister was when she was 3 as well. So it's a scary time. It's really important to try to stay healthy and learn as much as you can about the disease. And I'm here to promote all the new technologies there are to help treat the disease and also try to, you know, bring awareness to it and bring some funds to the JDRF and promote the walk that's this Sunday. The 4th at the Rose Bowl, and Frank's going to be emceeing it.
We'll be on the stage together as we are every year. Derek has been such an incredible role model, and you know this. I mean, the kids really look up to you. I mean, you're an example of how type 1 diabetes doesn't hold you back.
Thank you very much for saying that, Frank. Yeah. And that's always been really important to me. It's been one of my messages is because when I was a kid, there wasn't anyone who talked openly about being type 1 diabetic. There weren't people in the limelight. Right. Yeah. So with whatever kind of fandom that I can get, I want people to be able to relate. And I want to be able to talk openly about it because I've been through it, too.
Yeah.
Speaking of open, we talked to you about this before you came out here. There's a device that you wear.
Yeah.
And where is it and how's it working and stuff like that?
Yeah, I work with a company called Dexcom, and I've got a CGM. It's a continuous glucose monitoring system, and it's a little Bluetooth device that attaches to my stomach, and it tells your phone constantly what your blood sugar is. So most people think type 1 diabetic, they got to test their blood sugar, mm-hmm. you know, with a finger prick constantly, but this device makes it much easier so that you constantly know where you are. And not only do you know where you are, you know which way you're heading, so you get alerts whenever you get to dangerous highs or lows.
And Dexcom has, I mean, they've really upgraded just in the past year. The devices, everyone that I've talked to said is better than ever.
That's right. It is better than ever. The G6 is their new model, and I'm proud to wear it because it really is a life changer. It's
wow.
It's really state-of-the-art technology.
Yeah.
One quick professional question. Mm-hmm. I know you can only say a little bit about it, but the show American Gods,
right,
which is getting a lot of attention.
Yeah, I got to work for half my summer over in Toronto on the second season, and I've got a really great role, and I'm excited for people to see that. I can't talk too much about it, though.
All right. Is it more of a physical role than Baby Daddy?
It is. You know, I've always been a big superhero fan, and I've liked action movies and things like that, and a goal of mine was to be a type 1 diabetic and wear all of my devices under my superhero costume,
right.
And I get kind of an opportunity to do something like that in this show.
Oh, you're going to have to come back and talk about it when it comes out.
I would love to.
That'd be great.
I love being here, guys.
We'll tell you, here's JDRF One Walk to Cure Diabetes this Sunday. It's November 4th at the Rose Bowl Stadium. Registration starting at 8 a.m. Walk begins at 10 a.m. My guess is the KTLA Morning News Weekend Edition on Sunday is going to have a camera or two out there.
Yep.
Walkjdrf.org/Los Angeles. KTLA.com, more information as well. Good to
see you. Thank you, Derek.
Thank you so much for having me.
Great to see you.